Welcome to Daily Dose Radio, a 5-minute devotional podcast studying the Psalms verse by verse. Broadcast from the ever beautiful Sharonville, Ohio, on the sunny side of Cincinnati. Hey there, friends. Welcome back to Daily Dose Radio. This is your home for artisanal Bible study. It's organic, it's fresh, it's free of MSG and GMOs. This is 100% Bible, responsibly handled Bible study, and 5 minutes a day right here in the Bible Bistro. And today, what we're going to have for you is Psalm 83, verses 9, 10, and 11. And 9, 10, and 11 is going to take us back into our Bibles a little bit, because here we reference a memory that goes back into the Scriptures. So the prayer is continuing in this part of the Psalm. He says there in verse 1, "Keep not silence, hold not thy peace, be not still, O God, for your enemies make a tumult. They have consulted together with one consent," there in verse 5. And then, so we have this description of the enemy there in 3, 4, 5 through 8. We have all this talking about the evil that's there, that's present against the people of God. And then we come back to the prayer here in verse 9. Let me read 9, 10, and 11 for you. "Do unto them as unto the Midianites, as to Sisera, as to Jabin at the brook of Kishon, which perished at Endor. They became as dung for the earth. Make their nobles like Oreb and like Zeb, yea, all their princes as Zeba and as Zalmunna." As I said, this takes us back into the Scripture. "Do unto them as the Midianites, as to Sisera, as to Jabin at the brook of Kishon." Now, the Midianites, that first phrase in 9, that's one story. And then the second phrase in verse 9, "as unto Sisera, Jabin, the brook of Kishon," that's a second story. So that story, the second one, is where we'll begin. You go back to Judges chapter 4, and we're going to talk about there in Judges 4, the judge Deborah, when Jabin, the king of Hazor, decided that he was going to rule the northern part of the land, the northern tribes, and marshaled a great army, lots of chariots, and his commander was Sisera, and he was going to take over, and he was, you know, he had the military might to do it, but of course the Lord routed him through the prophet Deborah. The Midianites is referring to Oreb and Zeb and Zeba and Zalmunna. These are the ones that came in during the time of Gideon. So we'll go back to Judges 7. So in the first part there in 9, we have Judges chapter 4 reflected. Now in verse 11, we have Judges chapter 7 reflected. Two different judges. God did the same thing. He routed the enemy, completely destroyed them, and did it in a glorious, overwhelming way. He did it through the prophet Deborah with just a few, and he did it through Gideon with just a few. I always like to call Gideon the scaredy cat judge, because he was afraid, and God used his fear and taught him a lesson. His lesson was that God can save with many or few, and he chose on that day to save with few, 300 men, against the overwhelming might of the Midianite army. Oreb and Zeb are the captains or the generals of those armies, and they were completely cut off when they were captured and killed. And so this is what the prophet wants God to do now. Overwhelmingly, to show yourself to be God in this case and destroy the enemies of God. Let them know that they cannot attack heaven, and that if they touch your people, you take notice of that. That's kind of the prayer, because you'll notice it says there in verse 9, "do unto them as," and then in verse 11, "make their nobles like." So wants God to come and do a work again, just like he did in the past with the judges. Tomorrow we'll pick up right there and read verses 12 through 14 on Daily Dose Radio. Hey there, friends. Just wanted to remind you to go out and get yourself a copy of my new book, Christianity to the Life, by Cotton Mather, edited by me, David Smith. You can find it at Amazon. It's a paperback. It's also in Kindle form, so you can get it for your Kindle or you can get it for your library at home, however you'd like to have it. If you do, I really would appreciate if you would write a review after reading it. Let me know what you think. And it's a really good book. It'll encourage your Christian walk with the Lord. So go out and get Christianity to the Life today on Amazon. Thanks for listening to Daily Dose Radio. I'm David Smith. While on the internet, pick up a copy of my book, Small Does Not Mean Struggling, and Other Stories of Small Church Propaganda. The music today has been performed by the Bluegrass Experiment. Thanks again for listening. I'll see you next time on Daily Dose Radio.